exposed to numerous dimensions, and we only need to pursue our passion and chase our dreams. Then of course, success will be our doorstep. Today, we have a prolific session on If I Can, You Can Too. A panel discussion by some of our brilliant students with eyes that ignite your mind, to inspire and motivate you. We are presenting before you the budding professionals. In the list we have a very insightful student, Ms. Avishya Samal of class 12. The brilliant writer who has contributed in Who Lies Within, which is about the journey of self-discovery and finding out one's identity. Moving on, we have Ms. Jasmine Mahapatra, the brilliant student of class 12, with a superb creation, A Trip to My Village, which portrays the name Escape by the Youth of India, a collection of 100 stories and poems written by different people on the experience about visiting a place in India, embedded with special moments and thrilling adventure. The third member of the panel is Master Kaustav Agarwal, the dynamic student of class 12, honored to have his poems and essays published in 3 anthologies, Magical Verses, What's the Word, and A Bond Beyond Books. Ms. Narsa Jena is the fourth student to be in the panel, with her own collection of poems, polychromatic musings, dealing with various kinds of emotions, from appreciating nature to romanticizing life and death. Last but not the least, the enterprising member of the panel, Ms. Tisashi Swain, who is an avid reader, who trusts for reading never stops, finally makes her way to her honeysuckle daydreams, which is a product of her aesthetic mind and superb imagination. So let's welcome all 5 of them with a huge round of applause. I request our students to offer the doorstep to them and to welcome. For dealing with these dynamic writers, we need an equally competent and versatile moderator who has dived into the ocean of literature herself. So here we welcome honorable and talented Ms. Anjali Mishra, a student of class 12, to act as moderator of the session. So my dear audience, let's be a part of this brilliant session and enrich ourselves. Over to the panel now.
The belief in one's character, the zeal to do something new, and the efforts that lie within us would scream out to us to find out the world in front of us. That is literature. Literature is that lighthouse which keeps on spreading in the sea of time. And you see how beautiful literature is, that it has brought all of us to this beautiful literature conclave. So with this, good afternoon everyone, as all of us are here again to join a new yet exciting panel session with some of our young, dynamic and budding student authors on the very message, If I Can, You Can Too. So as I begin this session, I cannot wait to ask all of my inquisitive questions to these beautiful and amazing authors sitting right in front of me. Beginning with you, Disha. You have authored the book Honeysuckle Daydreams, and I can remember a very beautiful quote about it. I am no bird, No net ensnares me. I'm a human being who's born with a will to do something great. So how do you feel that literature sets your passion into fire?
Thank you for asking me that question, Anjali. But before I get to answering your question, I'll take a moment to talk about my book, Honeysuckle Daydreams. So my book is a series of diary entries, or more specifically, poetry addressed to someone I like. But because I can't voice out my affection to him, I take the medium of literature to express these complicated feelings. Now, much of the apprehension that I have is in general induced by the current society we live in. So this society we live in doesn't allow someone to love. Because of these rigorous and severe rules we have on who to love, when to love, how much to love, and of course, a strictly taboo list on who you cannot aspire to love at all. You see, sometimes we have these complicated feelings that we are not allowed to express. And we find lovesick couples, we don't tolerate lovesick couples on park benches, and we can't see people walking hand in hand in the streets. And these kind of things have convinced many of us that loving someone may be wrong. But you see, in this context, literature becomes that fluid medium that allows me to express my thoughts, my power, my emotions and feelings in a way that the society cannot despise. This literature has helped me look at everything and anything in a way from a point of view that I have never experienced before, and I swear to God, that is one of the most enticing things ever.
Wow, that's such an amazing way of expressing your love for literature. I mean, you have explained everything about what you believe in yourself and how beautifully the book that's in front of me. Would you like to show it to the audience? Your book, Honeysuckle Daydreams.
Sure. This is my book, Honeysuckle Daydreams. And if you want a copy, then you can order it on Amazon, Flipkart, and YouTube.
So the audience, you go out and check this amazing book. This is all about you, your feelings, your emotions, those unheard voices which deserve to be heard. Moving on to you, Nasha, I have heard that you have written a lot of poems in your book, Polychromatic Musings. My question to you is, literature is about discovering something extraordinary from ordinary people. It's about using ordinary skills and putting them in the most extraordinary way possible. So can you list few instances from your life which made you believe that ordinary skills can actually make your passion extraordinary?
Well, Anjali, you see, it's not any ordinary skill, but rather it's an ordinary person who lit the little spark within me to start writing. I never even knew I could write poems until I read one of Disha's works. I was totally moved by the intricate details she gave of the situation, people, emotion. She creates this pretty magical world with her crazy wordplay, and I feel like it's easier to thrive in there. And ever since then, it has been my habit of picking up ordinary objects, which are mostly overlooked, and weaving it into a poem. For instance, there's a poem that I wrote about how people are generally curious about the depths of the ocean. But you see, no one really questions the secrets that are hidden beneath the rocks. Sometimes the polka dots on the shirt of the guy I like become the inspiration of my poems, and sometimes the daisies on my tea table do the job.
For your such an amazing rendition about your book, I truly believe that we need to aspire to inspire others before we inspire. And you see, you've proven that so beautifully through your book, Polychromatic Musings. I'm sure the audience will definitely look out to read her book, Polychromatic Musings, which is all about an ordinary person who keeps on finding out something extraordinary. Thank you so much, Nasha. Kausar, you have a lot of interest
in science and the journals relating to science. So my question to you is, literature is at its best when it's described as a manifestation of one's personality. When you describe literature in the form of your personality, that becomes etched in the hearts of people forever. So how do you add life to your personality through literature?
To begin, I want to thank the school for this wonderful opportunity and also Anjali for this beautiful question. You see, Anjali, I believe that there is no better way to fathom one's personality than to read their thoughts. Literature is a very true and a very real portrayal of one's persona. My experiences with literature has led it to satisfy my curiosity whilst also engorging it even more. For instance, in my first book, The Magical Verses, I have written a poem, A Tale as Old as Time. Here, I describe the various stages of how life has developed on the earth, and I'm sure that reading it will boggle your imagination. Then, in one of my other books, The Words of Birth, I have written a series of micro tales where I have taken the inspiration from the great Einstein, and I have also used the unknown myth that he didn't use to cut his hair for the fear that he might lose his knowledge. In fact, I'd love to quote the first few lines here. Overgrown hair like a hat on my head, vanishing knowledge is what I dread. As it is exam season, Einstein is my inspiration. I remember it was during the 10th board exams when I wrote this, and this worked as the perfect stress buster. Reading my books and understanding my style of writing will surely prove it to you that literature doesn't only have to be emotional or romantic. It can be inquisitive, informative, with a scientific background too.
Absolutely, I truly agree with you. That's such an amazing thought and insight towards science. I mean, we all keep on debating about either science or literature. It shouldn't be either way around. We can juxtapose both the fields and then come out to a common ground. To all the science enthusiasts out there, use your words as your weapon. Put out your thoughts, your innovative ideas in the form of literature. And believe me, it will give you the reward that you want. Thank you so much, Kaustav, once again. Moving on to you, Anisha. You've written about self-discovery and about realizing one's inner potential in your book, Who Lies Within. So my question to you is, the crown of literature is poetry. The throne of poetry is literature. But the king is the writer. It's a writer who can create the message because he has both honor and responsibility in his court. So how does this metaphorical outlook of kingship inspire you to pursue literature as a career?
That was quite flattering, Anjali. Thank you. I'd like to say here, you are what you do. These are not mere words. When strung together, they form the mantra to a simple yet a very successful life. COVID-19 impacted all of us. We need to go back to the throwback old ways to read novels and comics to interest ourselves. Yet what we did was moved along with the digital era and went to watch TV shows, series, anything and everything OTT platforms could provide to us. What we saw were the heroes on the big screen. None of us even thought about, let alone give credit to the heroes working behind the scenes. The ones who actually pulled the strings of the show. The ones who pulled at the creative strings within their mind to provide us with such stories. Thing is, when people think of literature as a career, they imagine a person boxed up within a windowless room with an oil lamp, writing a novel with ink-spattered hands. Yet believe me, if you open one of these windows and chose to explore, there's a lot more to literature than you would know. Be it script writing, screenwriting, even songwriting, all of them have the term writing within it. That is, it traces its way back to literature. Take, for example, Taylor Swift. We all love her. And why? because her songs are story. The lyrics are poetry. All of us have a unique viewpoint to our lives, and it's time we took the risk to put it out of the world. And that is what all of us have done, and we got an opportunity to sit here.
That was really spectacular. I mean, the way you believe in yourself and the way you want the audience to believe in themselves, to bring out the best in their voice. So I think that all of us must realize that dreams are not something that you see during your sleep. Dreams are something that don't let you sleep. And you even spoke about dreams. But then I think that there are a lot of people out there who dream of writing. But then they think that, how can they put that dream into words? So how do you define your dream, and why do you think it makes you feel so special about your life?
Well, it's common, we all dream. We all want to leave behind our humdrum realities. But it's a gift, and interpreting a dream is a journey in itself. And it's our turn to take the risk to put this interpretation forward to the rest of the world to see. It is a bit difficult because it's going against the tidal current of the people. Yet it's a challenge, and it's sometimes we accepted it.
Thank you so much. Anasha, would you like to add on something to it?
Well, I want to add an interesting story of mine. So once I had a dream of writing a poem. It was a vague one, but I remember the central theme of it. And the ending phrase. So the next day, the first thing I did was weave a poetry centering around a particular theme and ended it with that very exact line. Technically, I didn't consider that I wrote that poem while I was asleep. As absurd and unrealistic as that sounds, it's true. And it's one of my favorite poems.
Wow. Well, that's something which we all need to look at. It's not necessarily that, but you are the top of your, like, it's the best day that you start drafting your poems and your writings, but it can also be from your worst days. When you feel low, when you feel depressed, and you have no one who can listen to you, you can put your words. And they are the ones who can make you feel special when you start reminiscing about them. Thank you so much, Nasha and Abhisha, for beautifully putting forward your ideas and opinions about dreams. And I'm very sure that all the people out there will chase their dreams and will make them turn into reality. Moving on to you, Jasmine. Literature as a career will not only enlighten the literary minds or the hearts out there, but they also create a change in the way we use literature as a language. They also create a kind of change in the way we interpret literature. And there have been a lot of authors who have brought up changes in the field of literature. How far do you agree on this?
You're absolutely right, Anjali. Well, I would fairly agree, as I myself want to take up literature as my major in college. I also believe that literature helps one to shift their perspectives from one's perspectives by putting ourselves in someone else's shoes. I have often heard people saying that I enjoy reading, but I don't want to take up literature as my major. Many others also say that I would take up literature, but only later. That is only after obtaining a secure degree for a secure future, because they believe that there are no broader variety. They don't have many career opportunities or choices in this field. If they take up literature, they won't be able to get a variety of options there. But I think that this is a very big misconception. Graduates who have obtained their degree in literature can have a variety of choices for their career opportunities. Like, for example, you can take the journalism, media, broadcasting, publishing, and also, as my friend Abhisha mentioned, entertainment as well. It can also help you as a complementary subject for studying law or for studying business. So I think it's pretty helpful and would also provide you with a variety of career choices if you take up literature.
Absolutely, I truly agree with that. So that's a courageous decision you made. You see,
options. But people who really believe and have the courage to accept the fact that yes, they do love literature and they enjoy living literature and they enjoy taking literature as a career. But that talks a lot about, it speaks volumes about your day as a writer. I wish you all the very best for all your future endeavors. Now, as you talk about how one can bring about change to literature, like we have had a lot of writers who have given stories, comedies, horror stories, or let's just say there have been a lot of biographies talking about personalities. So, once more, I'd like to ask Foster that people have this thing that they can create a pursuit within their readers and they wish to do that. But writers, they have that idea to come up with that pursuit. As you have come up with three different books, Magical Verses, Words Are Word, and Born Beyond Books. How have you created that pursuit within your readers?
First of all, let me assure that reading my book will teach you something new. It contains a very fresh and a very creative way of teaching, and in turn, it will build a hunger inside you, a hunger to learn. I have always wanted to be creative with my writings so that it has a scientific backbone to it, and it's very important that we realize that not only literature not only has to be emotional, we can also pursue science while translating it to literature, to words, and be happy with that too. I would ultimately love to pursue literature as my career and let people learn about the scientific beauty of literature.
Exactly. So that is, again, another inspiring statement given by you. You see, even I read a book by Paul Kalanithi, which is about when breath becomes air. And he, being a medical doctor, wrote this. He explained about the life of patients and how patients deal with it. So doesn't matter to whichever background or profession you belong, literature can always be open to you as a career. Thank you so much, Foster, for enlightening us with that. I'm still more curious to know about Abhishek's style of writing. And so my question to you was as such. Now, the fact that has been taken as a limitation has always been constant. So, can you recall a time when people or the audience or your readers objected your passion for writing? And how did you overcome that?
Well, the ones who love us, they get noticed the most. The thing is, this is where poetry became friction between me and my parents. I will not stop from giving credit where it's due. I'd like to thank my mother a lot for molding me into the amateur poet that I am today. Yet my parents weren't very passionate about the idea of me pursuing poetry as a career. So when I penned a poem for the anthology of Who Lies Within, it was more of a challenge for both of us. For them to trust me to make poetry a career, and for me to test the waters to see if literature could be a career. Well, it worked out just fine. They trust me that I can make a career out of poetry, and I have the confidence now to go ahead and make more poems in the future. And it's time even you thought of yourselves like that.
Thank you so much, Abhishek, for your such an exhilarating viewpoint about poetry. And yes, doesn't matter what limitations we face, but if we all believe in ourselves, we can definitely get it out. So moving on to the last question of this panel discussion, to Ms. Nisha. Now, in your book, Honeysuckle Daydreams, you have spoken about how one can overcome one's feelings of frustration and can come out with more innovative ideas. And you see, we meet with ourselves time and again in a thousand disguises on the path of life. So do you feel that sitting in this literature conclave has made you meet yourself in disguise? Anjali, life is ludicrously prone to change. At 8 a.m. we may feel okay. By 8, 7 a.m. we may have a mini meltdown. You see, some things leave us forever changed, turned inside out. All reaching limbs endlessly for an old self that we can't quite find.
We are not the same and we will never be. Now, when I am sitting in this literature conclave and I think back to the time when I started writing, God, I was horrible. I often marvel at how far I have come and how magnificent my road ahead will be. But when I think back to when I started writing and I was very horrible and I had different opinions than I have now, that's the beauty of being a beginner. You get to be bad. Your first draft gets to be the worst. Your first poem sounds awfully sappy. But then you write a second poem, weave a second draft. You get better and better with every new increment you give yourself. You change with every opportunity. And no matter on this journey how many versions of yourself you meet and how many of them feel deceptive and how many of them feel utterly close to the heart, the only thing that matters is that you stay true to yourself. Absolutely. Now your thing and your passion for writing is totally evident from your book. And yes, we have Honeysuckle Daydreams in front of us so the audience can go out and seek through the challenges that one faces in life and how one can think to overcome them, all with courage and firmness in your purpose. So as we all come to an end of this panel discussion, with the message that literature can truly be taken up as a career. If you believe in yourself, and if you have decided to write, then believe me, it will make you to reach to the pinnacle of your career. We have had great poets, and we have had great authors since the 18th century, and we still continue to have hope. So literature can be the best way to take up a career. And yes, just like Amishan and Jasmine said, that if you try to do something new in the pursuit of what sets your soul on fire, you will get through it. Time and again, you may meet yourself with different types of characters, but eventually, you will find yourself in the success of your book. Thank you so much, everyone, once again. And yes, this is a message to the audience. If I can, then you can too. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you to all the members of the panel. Really, it was a dynamic and magnificent session. And you all have proved that age is just a number. You all are children of hardly 16 or 17. But still, it was no less than the session which you attended in the first session. So thank you all. I wish you all the best for your future endeavor. Please be seated, students. Now we have the honor of requesting. Now, may I request you to go and occupy your places. Thank you, all of you. Thank you for inspiring and infusing all the young minds to tread the path of literature and to be great writers and poets. The great nature poet William Wordsworth has rightly said, poetry, the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. It takes its origin from emotion, recollected in tranquility. So whatever a poet composes in a particular mood, it's only difficult to probe into his mind or critically appreciate that and be no less how far he are successful in that. And the way how we interpret a poem is of course discussion. But what if we can add different sets of aesthetics into that? Art, action, music and dance to that. Yes, of course, the outcome will be exemplary and majestic. So here we are going to present this magnificent style in Kala Ashri, artist in initiation, Shubham Amalgamation to depict how Kala or artistic creation can be reflected in Arsi, a mirror. Presenting before you, Kavita, Krishna ki Chitavani, jisko Rashtra Kavi Ramhari Singh Dinkar ke Rashtrarathi Kavya Sangrah se diya gaya hai. Bhagwan Shri Krishna is challenging and mourning the Kauravas and showing his majestic and giant form, the Vishwarupa. So now, I request the student to have this wonderful performance.
सहद हूँ बखाम पानी पत्थर पांडव आए कुछ और लेकर सौभाग्य ने सब दिन सोता है देखें आगे क्या होता है मैत्री की राय बताने को सबको उस मार्ग पर लाने को दुर्योधन को समझाने को भीषण भीषण दुर्भर से बचाने को भगवान हस्तिनापुर आए पांडव का संदेशा लाए तो न्याय अगर तो आधा दो पर इससे भी यदि बाधा हो तो दे दो केवल 5 ग्राम रखो अपनी धरती तमाम हम वही खुशी से खाएंगे परिजन पर असी न उठाएंगे दुर्योधन वह भी दे न सका आशीष समाज के ले न सका उल्टे हरि को बांधने चला जो था असाध से साधने चला जब नाश मनुज पर छाता है पहले विवेक मर जाता है हरि ने भीषण हुंकार किया अपना स्वरूप विस्तार किया डगमग डगमग दिग्गज डोले भगवान कुपित होकर बोले संजीर बढ़ाकर साध मुझे हाँ हाँ दुर्योधन बांध मुझे हाँ हाँ दुर्योधन बांध मुझे यह देख गगन मुझ में लय है यह देख पवन मुझ में लय है मुझ में विलीन झक्कार सकल मुझ में लय है संसार सकल अमृत फूलता है मुझ में संखार झूलता है कुटिया चल मेरा दीप्त भार भूमंडल वक्ष स्थल विशाल कुछ परिधि बंध को घेरे है मैं नाक मेरे पग मेरे है दीप्ते जो ग्रह नक्षत्र निकट सब है मेरे मुख के दृग हो तो दृश्य अकांड त्रिग हो तो दृश्य अकांड देख मुझ में सारा ब्रह्मांड देख चर अचर जीव जग क्षर अक्षर नश्वर मनुष्य सुर जाति अमर शतकोटि सूर्य शतकोटि चंद्र शतकोटि सरित सर सिंधु मन शतकोटि सरित सर सिंधु मन शतकोटि विष्णु ब्रह्मा महेश शतकोटि जिष्णु जलपति धनेश शतकोटि रुद्र शतकोटि काल शतकोटि दंडधर लोकपाल संजीव बढ़ाकर साध इन्हें हाँ हाँ दुर्योधन बांध इन्हें भूलोक अतल पाताल देख कथ और अनागत काल देख यह देख जगत का आदि सृजन यह देख महाभारत बांधने मुझे तो आया है, जंजीर बड़ी क्या लाया है। यदि मुझे बांधना चाहे मन, तो पहले तो बांध अनंत गगन। सोने को साध न सकता है, वह मुझे बांध क्या सकता है। फिर वचन नहीं तूने माना, मैत्री का मूल्य न पहचाना। तो ले, मैं भी यह बचाता हूँ, अंतिम संकल्प सुनाता हूँ। याचना नहीं अब रण होगा, जीवन जय या की मरण होगा। टकराएंगे नक्षत्र निकट, बरसेगी भूम पर ध्वनि प्रकट। फणशेष नाग का डोलेगा, विकराल काल मुंह खोलेगा। दुर्योधन रण ऐसा होगा, फिर कभी नहीं जैसा होगा। थी सभा सज्ज, सब लोग गए, चुप थे या थे बेहोश पर। केवल दो नर ना आघाते थे, धृतराष्ट्र विदुर सुख पाते थे। करजोड़ खड़े प्रमुदित निर्भय, दोनों पुकारते थे जय जय। दोनों पुकारते थे जय जय।
यदा यदा ग्लानिर्भवति भारत, यभ्युत्थानं यधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम्। परित्राणाय साधूनां, विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां, धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे, संभवामि युगे युगे।
for creating this superb platform for the budding authors. My gratitude to all the student authors. And also a bucket full of gratitude to all dear students of Standard 9 and 11 who were there before some time. Really today we have a wonderful and fabulous audience. So a big round of applause for all of you. So with this we have come to the end of session 2. Now I request you to head towards your classrooms and we are about to start next session.